How's it going, guys? Right, the original Game Boy, the Game Boy Pocket, the Game Boy Color versus the Atari Lynx. Who's gonna win? Well, let's turn the lights out and see. It is the Atari Lynx, because with all the Game Boys, as soon as the lights went out, you couldn't play the damn things. While the Lynx and the Game Gear back in the day, if you had enough batteries to actually power the damn thing, you could play in the dark. And this was I thought was a major flaw with the Game Boy back in the day. And even when they were sort of starting at 1989, then getting to 1998, it's 9 years later and it still wasn't backlit. But there was a solution that did actually come out in Japan, which was called the Game Boy Light. Now, Nintendo being Nintendo, this baby actually came out in April of 1998 in Japan, and the Game Boy Color came out on October of the same year, 1998. So yes, as always, you buy a product and then 3 months later it's deemed completely worthless and you have to buy the new one. But that's Nintendo. So it's pretty much the same kind of size as the actual Game Boy Color. Same sort of thickness. It's slightly different on the back there. You can see on this one, it's got a smooth battery case, whereas the actual Game Boy Light was kind of ribbed. This one, I said it's the limited edition Astro Boy one, which I really like because it's skeleton version, so you can see all the innards and workings of the Game Boy itself. And you get the cool Astro Boy decal on the front. So yes, it's on top. The only real difference is it's got three switches on here. So it's one, two, and then three. So off, on, and then light when you move it over. So let's turn off the Lynx and we will turn on the Game Boy to start with. Right, so we've got Super Mario Land 2. Again, the screen is greatly improved on this as well. I think it's sort of a real sort of sharper monochrome screen, and so it's as good as it ever was. So let's turn off the lights and get this started. Right. So let's hit the backlight. There we go. If we can get it going. Put the contrast down a bit too much. There we go. Lighten it up a bit. So this might be quite difficult to see. And it's even harder to play while I'm filming at the same time. Try again. Oh, I'm not gonna do it again. There is still screen blur, but that's just the Game Boy. But you could play the Game Boy now in the dark. Let's turn the lights back on. So even with the backlight on this thing, you'd still get over sort of 10 hours continuous play, which is really good considering, i.e. something like the Lynx would cost you about £20 in batteries and would last about 45 minutes before it was on its last legs and dying. So Nintendo did source it, they sorted out the problem of the nighttime playing and still giving you really good battery life. But considering this came out before the Color, why didn't the Color have a backlight screen? You just wonder, really, what goes through their minds. They had the technology, they developed it, but they never actually released it. So this was only ever released in Japan, never made it to America or the UK. A real sort of, quite a rarity, really. These are some of the sort of hardest Game Boys to get hold of. And there was sort of three different special editions that came out in the light. You got a Pokemon edition, and then there was two different Astro Boy ones. This one, and there was also a red Astro Boy version as well. Now I actually managed to get this on eBay. It was hidden away in a Japanese auction, and a guy had listed it with sort of broken English. I ended up managing to get this delivered for, I think it was £62, which is just crazily cheap. These usually go for a couple of hundred pounds, and when they're boxed in good condition, they can sort of top about £500. So Yeah, it's got a really good deal on it. I was really happy. And I said I'd never actually seen one until I got this in the post. And I said I'm really impressed with this. It's cool. The backlight is a real nice feature. It's a shame they never included it on any of the other consoles. So that's just a quick look today at the Game Boy Lite. All right, guys, thanks a lot for watching, and I will catch you soon with some more reviews. You take it easy.
That's it, man. Game over, man. It's game over.